Good afternoon to the Honorable Jury members and the Chairperson and all the other members in the meeting. I am Asta Mahana and I am currently pursuing BSc Honours Forensic Science from Amity University, Noida. And today the topic of my poster presentation is microscopy and forensics. In this, I would be particularly talking about the scanning electron microscope, which has been recently come into use. So, about the introduction. Scanning electron microscopy has over the last few years become an indispensable tool for forensic investigation, allowing a focus on poorly visible or basically invisible microscopic traces of evidence by imaging, image comparison, and X-ray microanalysis. Since crime is a part of everyday's world, the samples for a forensic lab come from a very wide range of micromaterials. Recently, microscopic techniques have been improved to allow a far better match to the wide range of samples. Key in the forensic investigation is the validity of the proof, that is the accuracy, that the non-destructiveness of the measurement method and the speed of the analysis. Because of the nature of the forensic samples, any changes are undesirable because of their value as evidence in the proceedings, as well as their complexity and reproducibility of examination. Forensic scanning electron microscope is a good solution since one of the key technologies for the instrumentation is ESEM. Samples require no preparation and can be examined in the natural state. Traditional techniques such as scanning electrons and BS imaging and X-ray analysis can also be used on all the available modes of operation. Even non-conducting, outgassing, dirty, oily or wet samples can be examined non-destructively. No coating, no cutting, no drying, and no manipulation is used during the experiment in SEM, that is a scanning electron microscope. This has a much greater depth of field than optical microscopy and can hence provide much clearer images of fibers, hairs, bullets, cartridge cases, and other items that do not have a flat surface. Similarly, it is much more suitable than optical microscopes for studying shoe prints and similar clues. Now, here are some of the advantages and some of the applications where we use the scanning electron microscope. First is the detecting forgery. Examination of handwritten documents can determine which of the two intersecting lines was drawn first in order to detect forgery. The main problem with imaging uncoated paper surfaces is the charging effect. Paper is non-conductive and therefore, in the past, it was coated with a metal layer to eliminate charging at high kilovolts. After coating, written lines can only be imaged if the imprint has changed the topography of the paper. Today, instead of using a high kV for imaging, an extreme low voltage, that is 0.7 and 2.0, is used, and this allows imaging of paper in its natural state. Image shows two. Forensic SEM is ideal for investigating uncoated paper. In combination with the different imaging possibilities, such as SE and BSE signals, together with the signal mixing and image processing technique, the scanning electron microscope allows the solution of intersection problems to trace and prove forgeries in documentation. The next application is distinguishing the cause of textile fire damage. So forensic investigations of fibers by use of this microscope can be useful to determine the cause of textile damage like tears, cuts, fiber fractures, and bites. Earlier studies were performed to reveal a method whether SEM procedure could be a reliable tool in distinguishing between cuts and tears. Using this technique that allows gas in the chamber to reduce charging in combination with newly designed dedicated detectors to work under low vacuum conditions, it makes it possible to image these fibers charged without any sample manipulation technique like coating the sample. Therefore, these samples can be imaged in their natural state, and this also represents that this is a non-destructive technique. Now, the next application is of investigating paint chips. During car accidents, often small paint chips are left behind at the crime scene. These small paint chips can be investigated by use of SEM-EDX to determine the chemical composition of each individual paint layer in order to determine the color and manufacturer of the car. Paint fragments also often are left behind as evidence in connection with burglaries where they may be scrapped from doors and windows on entry or exit from the premises. The use of SEM can be helpful there. Using this microscope in a low pressure regime, again, it is possible to look at paint chips by using the detector details with large depth of focus. Coming to the next application, investigating the cartridge cases. In forensic science, a direct comparison of items is often very helpful. These may be fingerprint marks made by implements, fibers, hairs, bullets, and cartridge cases. Many of these items do not possess a flat surface. Therefore, examination under an optical microscope is often difficult. Because the SEM has a great depth of field, it can produce image covering a wide range of magnification and depths on many types of surfaces, including rough and curved surfaces. When comparing, for example, two cartridges and simultaneously in SEM, a reference image is first obtained from one of the cartridge cases and is stored digitally. Then the second cartridge case can be scanned by use of rotating the second sample and can carefully position the cell at the shell, and the recorded images can be overlaid with the reference images, allowing the two samples to be accurately compared. The possibility to image the samples at extreme low magnification up to 5 times will turn the SEM into a versatile imaging tool. Since bullets and cartridge cases contain a large amount of firearms residues, such as primer decombustion particles, also known as the gunshot residues or the GSR, precaution has to be taken not to contaminate the instrument when dedicated GSR analysis is required in the future. Ultrasonic cleaning could be a solution for this problem. The next application is investigating the gunshot residue particles. In forensic science, gunshot residue analysis is an important issue. The analysis of gunshot residue can be performed through dedicated GSR software, ensuring reliable, fast, and fully unattended analysis, even at the overnight period of time. The software also identifies other indicative particles, like the particles which originate from the bullet containing a large amount of lead, other particles of interest such as titanium and zinc that are found in lead-free ammunition. Also, other more environmental-related particles can be categorized by the system to provide additional information about the suspect and crime scene. So the particles are taken from the suspect normally by using a tape lift method. By this way, particles are transferred from the area of interest onto a small sample for further examination in the scanning electron microscope. The small stub area that needs to be examined is split into multiple fields, and each field is scanned one by one. The backscatter electron signal is used to detect the particles. Typically, the GSR appears as bright particles within the image, and by applying a threshold to the signal, the particles are distinguished from the background and their actual position is recorded. Thus, the electron beam to perform an X-ray analysis will revisit the particle. The emitted X-ray spectrum from each individual particle is compared to the classification scheme. This scheme consists of a maximum of 256 individual user definable classes. The GSR software also employs the latest advances in X-ray spectrum processing techniques by combining regions of interest, spectrum stripping routines, and rule-based analysis methods. The next application is fresh pollen on clothes. The SEM is so advanced that it can detect the fresh pollen on clothes easily. So when a person moves through a bush or a natural landscape, he may touch flowers, a tree, or any small plant for that matter on the ground. In general, the flower will drop some pollen that gets stuck to the clothing and hence can serve as a micro trace of a person's presence. Depending on the type of pollen and the weather conditions, these small traces can be used in an investigation. Imaging of pollen can be very delicate and some of them may dry out. In those cases, coating of these kind of specimen is out of the question, and good scanning electron microscope images are necessary to determine its species and the process of development. Not only in the pollen non-conductive, but in general, the clothing itself is non-conducting and will show great depth variation. Depending upon the type of pollen and matrix structure, clothing on the pollen may be well on top or as they lie beneath on the actual tissue. A good depth of focus and a good quality secondary image can reveal the fine structure of the pollen. So basically, the electron microscope, these are the applications that I have explained related to the forensic science. And the electron microscope comprises of three main features. That is, it consists of all the three ranges, high vacuum, low vacuum, and the particular special, the scanning electron microscope's mode. So all the three modes are combined in one instrument, which makes it further more useful to use only one electron scanning electron microscope instead of using three different equipment. Thank you. This was all from my side.